Fishin' Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin' Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Hot Defoe, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Denny Brower, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Mark Menendez, and I've got that fishing affliction.
I'm Bobby Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Chris Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
I'm Shaw Grigsby, and I got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here.
Might be a black crappie. Let me bend down here and get him. Oh,
Strike King Slab Hammer Crappie. Check it out. Is that a big old crappie?
Well, folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishin' Affliction time, and welcome into today's episode, part two of the certified fan favorite, Slab Hammerin' Crappie, with the legendary Harold Morgan. And folks, he sure is teaching us how to catch those big old slabs. Today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight is on the great electronics that you can get from bbgmarine.com. And if you haven't got your Fishin' Affliction gear, then be sure to check it out there at our online store. If you can't get enough Fishin' Affliction TV, then be sure to subscribe to us there at our YouTube channels. And at the end of the show, you'll meet the Fishin' Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week. So sit back and enjoy this certified fan favorite, part two, Slab Hammerin' Crappie with the legendary Harold Morgan, right here on Fishin' Affliction TV.
Exciting, just exciting. Big slab crappie. Oh, come up in here. Look at there. Another nice, beautiful crappie right there. Man, it's just a tank, folks. If you know what you're looking for, this is what the result can be, especially if you position yourself right, put on the right type of bait. There's all kinds of great baits out there, but of course, you know, we're blessed to be sponsored by Strike King, as well as all our wonderful sponsors that we have. And I'll tell you what, everything that these folks make will catch those crappie, from the pole to the line to the reel and to that Strike King bait. Goodness gracious, another slab. These fish are just positioned on this long piece of wood, up and down it, and they're just working that bait by there, and folks, they are just hammering it. They're slab hammering it.
Well, folks, as you can tell, I'm having a great time chasing those big old slab crappies on Old Hickory Lake, and one of the most important factors about catching these particular crappie was making sure you made a precise cast in order to catch them.
All right, I'm back in the ball game. I think I got my line right now. When I mean my line, I'm talking about where I'm casting. And folks, that's very, very important. Position of fish is something that is sometimes not considered as much as it should be. What side of the log are they on? Are they high or are they low? Are they in the deeper part? Are they in the top part of the log or the treetop or whatever? This little area where I'm fishing, it's a laid down tree. And with the sun going in and out, I'm off the log. I can see it when the sun's out. Right now, the sun just popped out and I can see it. And I'm thinking that is the place to be, and it looks like I was off about 3 or 4 feet. There he is, and there you go. And I can't begin to tell you how important that is right there, and that it's a great demonstration. That's a blessed demonstration right there when you're talking about it and then you do it. But sure enough, oh folks, what a slab, what a slab. My gosh. My goodness. You know, sometimes, that's number 12, look at there, 12. Sometimes when you're doing what you're doing, you don't realize that you know, maybe the position of the fish are still there, but your cast is not there. So with that said, I'm gonna do what I can do to catch three more, and let's see if we can do it.
Well, as I put this crappie in the live well, let's find out from the legendary Harold Morgan what's his favorite type of jig to throw when he's fishing for slab crappie.
What's your favorite rig to be throwing when you're casting?
I still like the curly tail to throw because it's working itself back. Now, you take an umbrella jig and you can put a lot of them under floats. They're more, I think, the vertical fishing for those kind.
Okay.
But a jig, a curly tail, you can throw out and then start reeling in. Now, sometimes when reeling in, if you find a fish, watch your hand and know how much you're reeling. And if it gets fast and you caught that fish, they go back that fast. If he's slow and you caught him real slow, go back to that, because that's where the fish are wanting.
And that's a very important thing to be able to do, is to adapt.
It is.
Especially, and that can happen throughout the course of the entire day.
That's right.
You know, another thing I want to say about putting yourself on the spot, you know, GPS is only a portion of finding your spot, isn't it? GPS marks that coordinate, but then you have to mark it with either a marker like I have, and then if you have that out right, then you have to know how that structure is laying there so you can fish it appropriately, and then you've got to figure out how the fish are relating to that. In this situation right here, they've been so far halfway up the log in terms of the length of the log, and now it seems that they're a little bit further back. And I do have this cloud cover that's changing the position of the fish a little bit, it seems anyway. And of course, obviously, I've caught quite a few off of here, so I can't expect them just to feel undisturbed. So, and they're gonna be really undisturbed if I can't keep my line from on tangling up. I'm so excited that I get in a hurry sometimes. And that's another thing too. Whenever you're doing something, you know, enjoy the moment. It always doesn't happen just like this, huh? All right, let's see if we can get number 13. There he is. All right. This could be 13, folks. This could be. This one's a little bit smaller than we've been catching. But you know what we have? We get the handy-dandy Fraybill Fish Checker. We're gonna use it on this one.
Well, folks, this one looks a little bit short, and when we get back, I'm going to show you something that happened to me that I sure don't want to happen to you when you're out there in the wilds chasing those big old crappie. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, feeling lucky. That's exactly how Reddick Smith feels with this big, beautiful Percy Priest hybrid that he caught. And speaking of lucky, this is the world-famous Lucky Cowboy with an absolute monster lake trout that he caught while wearing his Lucky Fishing hat. And folks, this is the short junior fishing team. That's Hillary, Lily, Devin, Kurt, and Max with a beautiful rainbow that they all caught together. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to upload them to our Facebook page, and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild, your pictures in the wild.
At Strike King, it starts with the concept. Next, it's all about perfecting the prototype. Finally, it's about catching a dream.
This is a new prototype crankbait we're working on. Strike King. It's called a 10XD.
Strike King 10XD.
Wow! A 5-pass limit!
Perfection to 25 feet and beyond. Catch your dream.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Reach, throw, row, but don't go. Use this simple phrase to remind you what you should do if someone were to fall into the water without wearing a life jacket.
While holding on to the dock or boat, reach your hand, paddle, or whatever else you have nearby out to the victim. If you can't reach the victim, throw things that float for them to grab. And if you're in a boat, shut off the engine's motor and row up to the person.
Finally, don't go into the water unless you are trained. Even a strong swimmer can drown while helping others. So remember, reach, throw, row, but don't go.
The Turn Trail, for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, there's a lot of you that are fishing tournament trails out there, and there's a lot of you that want to follow the progress of those who are fishing those trails. And the best way to do it is right there at our Fishin' Affliction Facebook page. If you're fishing a trail or a tournament, feel free to post the results there at our Facebook page, and you can keep up with others like Slammin' Sam Lashley, The Machine Toby Lillard, Miss Laura Mae Cochran, and of course our very own Big Dog, while they're fishing the tournament trail. Our many thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail, and now back to Fishin' Affliction TV.
There he is. This could be 13, folks. This could be. This one's a little bit smaller than we've been catching. But you know what we have? We got the handy dandy Craybill Fish Checker. We're gonna use it on this one.
Well, folks, sometimes you get so wrapped up and excited in what you're doing, and in this case, I'm chasing and trying to catch a limit of slab crappie. And I just caught a short fish, and I'm about to measure it, and when I do, I realize that I have measured the last several fish with the wrong measuring mark.
Okay, just caught number 13. Let's see if it's going to measure. I believe it's going to. And you know what, folks? Uh-oh. Folks, let me tell you what I just did. I made a mistake, an honest mistake, but still a mistake. The Freebill Easy Checker, the grip and check, they're marked. And you can see that there's a serrated little area. And I wasn't paying attention. The bottom mark is 9 inches, the top mark is 10. The last two fish that I just checked, they are actually 9-inch fish. Fortunately, I saw that in my excitement to catch a limit. I did something that would have, you know, obviously been illegal. Although not intentional, regardless, still illegal. So you gotta pay attention. Get so excited that you're measuring fish and you're hoping that they are what they are, and folks, oh well, okay, so now I'm back to 11. All right, folks, let's see how many we have. One. Two. Folks, look at this thing. Look at that thing. That's number two. Look how big it is, two.
Well, folks, as I get a recount and double check the size of these crappie, let's talk to Mr. Morgan about the times and how they've changed.
What are the changes that have happened in the last 15, 20 years of crappie fishing?
Well, fishing back then was so great. It was just, man, we'd go out, and I guess this is the reason why fishing turned around not as good as it was, because we would go out and we was catching anywhere from 125 to 150 a day. And, you know, fishing 6 days a week, you're going to take a lot of fish, because every day you didn't always catch that. But back then, fish was plentiful. You could really catch a lot of fish. There was no limit. There was no size limit. And so everybody just in the crappie fishing would just try to get as many as they could, trying to beat the other fellow, I guess.
Sure.
But you know, you didn't, if we just never thought we were going against the gun by
right.
fishing all and bringing all them fish home, you know, every time. I wouldn't bring them home. I'd give them, of course, my customers got them, sure. You know.
But you have been instrumental in a lot that has to do with the laws that we experience today, and so many of those you've been asked your expert opinion about what a size of a fish should be or how many should be taken.
Right. And to me, at the time, it didn't seem to be on size limit. I thought it was a pretty good idea because it would fishing was begin to get scarce.
Three. 4. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, folks, we've got 10 crappie. A couple of them are small, meaning, oh no, we don't. I see 11 right there. Never mind, we have 11. Oh, 11 keeper crappie. We just need 4 more for our limit. Awesome. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I see where I've broken some of my line off and it's in the water there. And I don't want that stuff to stay out there. Maybe a turtle or a bird or something will get in it. So I'm gonna go get that and we'll just keep on fishing right after that.
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying our Slab Hammerin' and Crappie special and our visit with crappie fishing legend Harold Morgan. And in a moment, we're gonna be back with some more crappie fishing action and how to fish for those slabs when those weather fronts start moving through. But right now, it's time to head upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Cleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter. A lot of times we decide to go out on the boat at the very last minute. So today I have a recipe for you that's not only healthy but also really quick. It is my creamy fruit dip. And now for the ingredients. You will need fat-free instant pudding mix, fat-free Cool Whip, low-fat cream cheese, skim milk, Splenda, and fruit. After you've softened your cream cheese, blend it until smooth. Next, add your milk. Now your Splenda. Your instant pudding. And last, your Cool Whip. And now mix this again until it's nice and creamy. Keep this dip chilled and add your favorite fruit and you will have a healthy and quick boat snack. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
As fishermen, we're predators. And fish are the prey. In nature, the best fishermen have one thing in common, their eyes. How do you turn your eyes into the eye of a predator? It takes 11 layers of lens technology and a new lens color to make the human eye emulate the eye of a predator. Stop buying glasses for the classes. Make yourself an alpha predator.
I don't think Dan and Rusty will care if I do a few of my dug outdoors here on the water since they're so at home here. And I'm here to tell you that please wear these things now that we're in the fall and winter. If you haven't been wearing them all summer because they're too hot, no excuse now. Water temperatures are dropping fast now in Tennessee. Saw them in the mid-80s this year, now in the mid-60s where I'm on the water today on the Cumberland River. When this water temperature gets down further, it gets into those 50s and even 40s and you fall in and you can't get out. Chances of your surviving go down a lot. Plus, it's just smart. Get you an inflatable jacket. This one is a hydrostatic, goes off with 2 inches of pressure. Whatever you wear, old style jacket, the orange ones, I don't care. Just wear something and it will help save your life, I promise. I've been covering it too long for the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency to know that life jackets don't work. They're almost fail-proof, they're not perfect, but they're awful close. See you next week right here on Fishin' Affliction.
Folks, on today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, I want to tell you about bbgmarine.com. This is your online store for all your marine electronics, mappings, cartography, all the spare parts that you need for any of your depth finders. Brian Lieva at bbgmarine.com is a good man to deal with, and he sure has helped us here at Team Fishin' Affliction. When you get a chance, go to his online store, bbgmarine.com, check out the incredible inventory that he has, and talk to Brian and tell him that Team Fishin' Affliction sent you. And now back to Fishin' Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, King Sailfish Mounts for that catch of a lifetime. Inox, the supreme lubricant. Wigwam Socks, the performance sock company made in the USA. Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts. Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com. And Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
And now another exciting episode of Dan vs. Fish on Fishin' Affliction TV.
Marine electronics have come such a long ways, haven't they? And folks, today I'm going to talk a little bit about the necessity to learn your electronics. So many times we get something, we take it out of the box, and we expect it to work right away and to be a benefit for whatever it is that we're using, whatever application we've bought it for. And the fact of the matter is, today's marine electronics, well, they're just not like they used to be. They've always been complicated to some degree, but now, my gosh, these are nothing but computers, and there's so many layers and levels of technology that are typically untapped by us fishermen. And there's only one way to get familiar with the machine, and that's to spend time with it. And folks, another thing, just because you might have some older units that are not this new high-tech stuff, that doesn't make those older units not extremely, extremely good at what they do. And I would suggest that all of us would benefit from spending a little bit more time learning how to use the technology that's provided to us. Well, that wraps up this featurette of Dan versus Fish, which is really more like Dan versus Marine Electronics. So let's get back to some fishing action while I try to figure out how to turn this unit back on. Well, heck, that ain't it.
You're watching Fishin' Affliction TV for those who've got it bad.
Crappie fishing during a front. That's exactly what I'm using this Kentucky rig for. Mr. Harold Morgan says it works, and we've got the front. Conditions are great to try it, and I'm going to. This is a warm front that's behind a cold front. So the cold front's already come through, starting to warm up. But as you can probably hear on the camera, it's windy. And as you can see behind me, well, there's patches of rain clouds behind me. And let's see if this Kentucky rig, tricked out with these Strike King Tutti Frutti's and Slab Hammers, will put a crappie or two in the boat. Well, maybe, maybe, maybe a slab, maybe, maybe. Oh my goodness. Oh, let's get the free build that. Woo! Mr. Harold Morgan, he sure knows. Man, he's so right about that Kentucky rig. I don't have a lot of experience throwing it, but look at there. After just literally, probably, oh, I don't know, about 2 weeks of getting out, spending a little bit of time with this Kentucky rig on the recommendation of Mr. Harold Morgan, check it out. Just a beautiful, that's a white crappie, folks.
Well, let's see if I can get show that to you. Isn't that cool? I think you'll be able to see him. Oh, well, let me see if I can get, oh, God, a little bit bigger than what I expected. How about that, huh? Another Kentucky rig, big slab crappie. Well, how's that for a Tutti Frutti crappie, huh? Man, that's a good one, too. Nice white crappie. Put a little lighter Mustad jig head on. And that Tutti Frutti jig comes in so many different types of styles. And now there is a Mr. Crappie Strike King series of baits that are just some outstanding baits. But look at that. And just a big old fish. All right, folks. Oh, how about that for some crappie? And as a special treat, there's a few egg fish here. Looks like maybe, oh, looks like maybe 3 out of the 4. So guess what? Listen here. I want to show you where I'm going to do. Right there. And okay. Being the ultimate conservationist, right? You know, it's always great to turn fish like that loose. It's getting real close to the spawn. And if I put those fish in the freezer, they're not going to go through the spawn, are they? Always consider how much fish you have in your freezer and how much you need in your freezer. And if you don't need them and you don't know if somebody else that needs them, well, put them back and come back and get them again. That's what the beauty about catch and release is. It sure makes us have the opportunity to do exactly that. Come back and do some more fishing. Fishing during fronts, cold to warm to rain. Now, if you look behind me there, that is some dark stuff over there because it's raining at the boat ramp. The Kentucky rig worked really well today. Deep water structure using the Strike King baits there, the Tutti Frutti, and now the Mr. Crappie baits that have the little twisty tail. And they really worked well. And when that bite stopped, I grabbed a single jig and I was able to get a few more bites and a few good more quality fish. Well, let's head back to the HD studios and visit with crappie fishing legend Harold Morgan as I get myself back to the ramp with my Onyx life jacket and my Onyx rainwear. Looks like I better get that stuff out, huh? And you had mentioned to me that sometimes they actually do some of their spawning actually in the trees, Harold, in the brush?
Oh yeah, they'll get right up in those brushes and spawn if it's shallow.
If it's shallow.
Yeah, but now gravel and pea gravel is the two best things in the world for them to look for. If I was going to a new lake or any place new that I don't know at all, I would look for pea gravel banks or a sandbar. Get your map and look for sandbars and stuff like that. That's where crappies lay their eggs a lot.
And they lay those eggs springtime, water hits that 64 to 67 degree temperature area.
Right.
And then they start migrating back to what is referred to as deep water. And this is the misconception that you've told me. Deep water doesn't have to be 30 foot of water.
That's right. It don't have to be 30 foot of water.
And if I remember right, your lucky number is 17.
17 foot. That's right.
I'm so glad that we've had the time to visit on Fishin' Affliction. Thank you for taking the time.
I've enjoyed it. I sure have. And appreciate everything you've done for me.
Let's go out and see if we can catch them sometime.
We'll do that, yeah. Maybe we'll make a film on it.
I hope so. I think we got us a good camera gal that can do it, you think?
Yeah, I think so. And a good looking thing,
she
too,
is a good
you know.
Looking too. Thank you, V, for doing the camera stuff today.
Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed these last two certified fan favorite shows as we've had the blessed opportunity to visit with the legendary Harold Morgan as he's taught us how to catch those big old slabs. And folks, would you believe that we're already at the end of season 13 of Fishin' Affliction TV? 169 episodes and still going strong. So tune in to Fishin' Affliction TV next week and you'll see
the best of season 13.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is
James Parks.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt the Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
Crappie fishing, ready? Three, two.
This is Vicki Porter, the queen of crappie fishing.
And this is Harold Morgan, the crappie fishing legend.
Oh, get out of here.
You guys are great.